In this video, I'm going to show you 7 nail hacks every nail professional should try. These hacks saved me time and money and will help you achieve the same. If you are interested in working faster and smarter, and maybe even impressing your clients, this video is for you, so keep watching. So in today's world of technology, a business card holder is probably not your most coveted item, right? But what if you can repurpose this nifty book to store all of your decals and transfer foils and even your cellophane paper, right? You literally just need tape and a business card and just some extra time, which you probably want to use anyways to stress bust between clients, right? So tape a little bit of the tape at the end of your foils, attach it to your business card, and just simply roll that foil paper around that business card until there is no more to roll. You know, just stick it in one of the business card pouches. Now you might be thinking, well, I already have storage for my foils, right? Doesn't it already come in some sort of storage container? They do, they usually do. But the really cool thing about this is that a lot of times clients want to ask, or they ask about what you have, what your nail art looks like, and so on and so forth. You can literally take this folder and be like, have at it while I continue doing your nails. Now, we are all obviously very familiar with a lint roller, especially if you really enjoy wearing black clothes like I do. But what if you can repurpose this lint roller to help you with your nail art stamping? Yep, so we're very familiar with the process of stamping. You apply the paint, you scrape it, and then you pick it up with a squishy kind of guy, also known as a stamper. Many, many times we don't like our first images and we go ahead and rub it with alcohol, right? But what if you can just take a lint roller, right? And just press that stamper onto it without damaging your stamper and without getting all dirty and dry and dehydrated with an acetone or alcohol solutions, which by the way, do kind of wear and tear on your stamper. All right, so our next nail hack is an eyeshadow brush. And you might be wondering, of course, what about it? Well, just like you will blend makeup on an eye, you can actually take an eyeshadow brush and blend your pigments onto the nails to create very, very easy radiance. And I will show you the technique, right? So you apply a little bit of base coat onto your nail, or if your color has some sort of sticky residue to it already, then you don't have to apply base coat, but I applied a little bit of base coat to it. And you want to start with very, very little product and you apply it at the tip. You want to work very, very carefully and start applying your pigment like so. And just work it as if you were working that eyeshadow on your eyes. You don't want to use a lot of pressure. It's called the blending brush. So you need very, very feather type movement strokes and feathering, right, to get this ombre gradient. And by the way, we do have a video on our library. It's under nail art tutorials, and I show you specifically step by step how to go through this technique of ombre nails using an eyeshadow brush and pigment. Very, very easy. So our next nail hack is the dappin dish. And we know that a dappin dish can hold liquid, whether it's acetone or monomer for acrylics. But what if we can give that dappin dish, which has been around for many, many years, a new use? And that would be with all of your cuticle bits and removal bits. Oftentimes we just drop them into our sanitizer and sometimes we hope, right, and wish that they return. I've lost mines at the bottom of my sanitizer many a time. So take your dappin dish and drop that little guy into the sterilizer. And when you're ready for your next service, voila, there it is. There they are, all of them. All right, so our next nail hack has to do with nail forms, which many of you probably have not befriended yet. And perhaps One of the reasons is because once you've spent your time, you know, putting them on nice and firm, your clumsy client, right, just keeps knocking them before she goes in for a flash cure. So if you have nail forms that have long wings, simply take a pair of scissors and trim the excess. Now, these are relatively short, but many nail forms actually have very long wings, and you want to make that process as smooth as possible, being that nail forms and nail extensions are already quite stressful. Now, the next hack will have you producing content on your social media really often, really easy, perhaps even with every other client. And the way you will do this is either taking double-sided tape or those things you snap off and on, and you just put it on your lamp unit right above your service and hit record. Now, I would recommend that your phone is connected to a source so that it does not run out on battery. There you go, easy. And last but not least, my last nail hack is actually one that you're kind of familiar with, and that's using a tiara, right? A very small tiara to hold your brushes. It's very, very easy. You can find a tiara like this on Amazon and eBay, and it'll hold most of the time at least two brushes, sometimes even three. This one's a little tinier, so that's all that it will fit. But isn't that very, very cute and very handy? Thank you for watching. If you love these professional nail hacks, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to learn even more. And because I do have even more coming your way, don't forget to also click the notification bell to instantly be alerted once my next video is published. It is now time to turn it over to you. Which hack will you be impressing your clients with ASAP? Let me know below. Don't forget to check out my freebie by visiting paolaponcenails.com/liftingmistakes. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.